Okay, so this video is weird for me. I'll tell you more on that after you have successfully subscribed. Okay, you have done it. So now let's talk about why is this video so weird. I don't know what this smartphone is going to be called. All I know is that it is probably some Galaxy A series phone. It could be Galaxy A3 series, A5 series, A8, A7, A9, could be anything. For a guess, it will probably be something of a Galaxy A8 because if we look back, the Galaxy A8s was the first Samsung smartphone to have a hole punch camera, then the Galaxy A80 was the first dual rotating cover camera, so this probably has to do something with the A8. Could be A81, A8 Plus, A88, I don't know. For the first time ever, I am recording the video and I don't know what the name of the smartphone is. I don't even know what I'm going to title this video as. Now coming back to the actual smartphone, it's the first Samsung smartphone with a normal pop-up camera. The Galaxy A80 had a weird rotating flip-up camera, whereas this is the first Samsung phone to have a normal everyday pop-up camera similar to what was present on the OnePlus 7 Pro. This will make it a completely seamless display and small bezels all around. These are not the smallest bezels on any smartphone, but for a mid-range phone, I think they are good enough. This is the back of the smartphone. It's quite good looking, much better looking than the Galaxy S20 Ultra. The cameras are in a single line, we got triple shooters, most likely wide, ultra wide and optical zoom, then we have a flashlight. Also we still do have a rear mounted physical fingerprint scanner. I still do prefer it at the back more than the in-display ones, but hey, that's just my personal opinion. The Samsung logo is at the bottom and the power button volume rockers could be found on the right hand side. The back material itself look like glass, but Samsung's glassic back is also quite premium looking, and honestly, real story, I actually believed that the Galaxy A phones had a glass back, and I was shocked to find out that it's glassic and not glass. So all I wanna say is that even if it's glassic, it's not that big of a deal. At the bottom there is the charging port with USB-C, then we have the speaker grill and microphones. Sadly, Samsung has done away with the headphone jack on this smartphone as well. They removed it from the flagship phones last year, and this year they are also going to kill it from the mid-range phones. I think Samsung should keep it on the cheaper and mid-range phones because those buyers still haven't upgraded to wireless just yet. On the top we have the SIM tray, and what is this hole? An IR blaster? Could be, but it's too big for that. It's not a headphone jack for sure, and I don't have any confirmation on what it is, nor do I have any good ideas what it is for. If you have any ideas what it can be used for, just let me know in the comments section down below. Also, ZTech Care called this smartphone as the Galaxy SE. And buddy, I just don't see it. The iPhone SE is a compact phone with big specs, and this phone has a display of 6.5 inches. Physically, it will be almost the same size as the Galaxy S20 Plus. If Samsung makes a Galaxy S7 with a camera from S20 and Snapdragon 865, then that will be a Galaxy SE, not this at all. This might be at almost the same price as the iPhone SE, but that doesn't make it the Galaxy SE. If a less than $400 price is all it takes to be a Galaxy SE, then Samsung already has a bunch of Galaxy SEs lying around. Let me know guys your thoughts about this smartphone. What do you guys think about it? Also, just let me know what is this hole. I'm getting furious about it. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you want more such videos. Hit the like button if you enjoyed. And guys, thanks a lot for watching.